Hi everyone, I'm Sheena and I'm with the Commercial Horticulture team here at University of Maryland Extension, and today we're out at our Crapemyrtle plots. You probably have one of these trees in your landscape. They're great, they're tolerant of a lot of conditions, and they're blooming right about now or at the end of that period. There's also a new pest that's been in this area for several years called Crapemyrtle bark scale, and that does attack these trees. If you're seeing a lot of sticky substances underneath your crepe myrtle or unusually dark colored bark, that could be honeydew and sooty mold from the crepe myrtle bark scale. Check the bark and you'll see white fluffy substances, which is actually the insect's waxy cover. You can see that right here. Oh, we have ants feeding on the honeydew. So a lot of times you'll also see ants feeding on the honeydew from the bark scale. However, there are a lot of predators that feed on this pest. So before you worry about what should I spray, take a look at what's in your landscape. For example, we have a lacewing egg here. Very small, might be hard to see. And there are lots of syrphid flies and little wasps flying around the flowers. The larval stage of these insects will feed on the crapemyrtle bark scale. And there's also another one that looks very similar to the crapemyrtle bark scale. So this might throw a lot of people off. It's actually a lady beetle larva, and it is also white and fluffy, but this one is fluffier. And it has legs and also moves around. Once the crepe myrtle bark scale reaches the stage that it is white and fluffy, it will not move around. So that is a great telltale sign. The reason why we have these crepe myrtles out here is because we're trying to get this pest established to do life cycle studies on it. But we can't get it established because we've had so many of these beneficials show up on their own. So definitely look for them in your landscape before you worry about the fate of your crepe myrtle.